legend you are about to hear is true. Only the needle should be changed to protect the record.
This is the countryside. My name is St. George. I'm a knight. Saturday, July 10th, 8:05 p.m. I was working out of the castle on the night watch when a call came in from the chief. A dragon had been devouring maidens. Homicide. My job. Slay him. You call me, chief?
Yeah, it's the dragon again, devouring maidens. The king's daughter may be next.
Mm-hmm. You got a lead?
Nothing much to go on. Said you take that .45 automatic into the lab to have him check on it?
Yeah. You were right.
I was right?
Yeah. It was a gun. 8:22 p.m. I talked to one of the maidens who had almost been devoured. Could I talk to you, ma'am?
Who are you?
I'm St. George, ma'am. Homicide, ma'am. I want to ask you a few questions, ma'am. I understand you were almost devoured by the man. Is that right, dragon?
It was terrible. He breathed fire on me. He banged me already.
How can I be sure of that, ma'am?
Believe me, I got it straight from the dragon's mouth.
11:45 p.m. I rode over the King's Highway. I saw a man. Stopped to talk to him. Pardon me, sir. Could I talk to you for just a minute, sir?
Sure, I don't mind.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a knave.
Didn't they pick you up on a 903 last year for stealing tarts?
Yeah? So what, do you want to make a federal case out of it?
No, sir. We heard there was a dragon operating in this neighborhood. We just want to know if you've seen him.
Sure, I've seen him.
Mm-hmm. Could you describe him for me?
What's to describe? You see one dragon, you've seen them all.
Would you try and remember, sir, just for the record? We just want to get the facts, sir.
Well, he was, you know, he had orange polka dots.
Yes, sir.
Purple feet, breathing fire and smoke.
Mm-hmm.
And one big bloodshot eye right in the middle of his forehead, and, like that.
Notice anything unusual about him?
No, he's just a run-the-mill dragon, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir, you can go now.
Hey, by the way, how are you going to catch him?
I thought you'd never ask. A dragon net. 3:05 p.m., I was riding back into the courtyard to make my report to the lab. Then it happened. It was a dragon.
Hey, I'm the fire-breathing dragon. You must be St. George, right?
Yes, sir.
I see you got one of them new 45 caliber swords.
That's about the size of it.
You slay me.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about.
What do you mean?
I'm taking in a 502. You figure it out.
What's the charge?
Devouring maidens out of season.
Out of season? You never pinned that rap on me. Do you hear me, cop?
Yeah, I hear you. I got you in a 412, too.
A 412? What's a 412?
Overacting. Let's go.
On September the 5th, the dragon was tried and convicted. His fire was put out, and his maiden devouring license revoked. Maiden devouring out of season is punishable by a term of not less than 50 or more than 300 years.
Terribly sorry, but your dog has been seriously injured. There's not a lot we can do to help her.
Oh, dear.
Are you sure there's nothing we can do?
There is an operation we can do, but I'm afraid it would cost several thousand dollars.
Well, we may be able to do something.
George, we can't afford a bill that big.
But Sparky has been at my side for the last 10 years. I just can't put her to sleep if there's something we can do.
I love Sparky, too, but we can't afford to go this deep into debt.
Doctor, isn't there anything else we can do?
I'm sorry. I'd do it for less, but...
No, Doctor. We understand.
Maybe we could rent out the spare bedroom. There's got to be something we could do to save Sparky.
The value of a life can be measured by what we are willing to sacrifice for it. Have you ever thought about the value of human life? Have you ever thought about your value? God has. He sacrificed His Son to save us from our sins. That makes your life valuable. Do you know this loving God? Another message from Lifeline Productions, located on the web at lifelinepro.com.